you're my cameraman?
Sure.
All right. So we have a boxer's fracture with a 45-degree angulation. So the fracture is right here. It's 45 angles towards the volar surface here. I'm going to do a hematoma block, which is blood, essentially in the blood clot that's there from the broken bone. So we go at the fracture site, we pull until we get blood, then we know we're in the right place. And then we put a bunch of medicine in there. So it does burn, it does hurt, buddy. There's no way this is part of the painful procedure, all right? At one.
Suck it up.
And at two.
Suck it up.
Yeah.
There you go.
Oh, good job.
And then I usually inject a little bit first just to start giving him some relief, but I didn't get to the blood part yet, so I'm going to try to go a little deep. Put some more medicine in.
Good job, man.
And there, got a little bit of blood into the syringe, so you can see how it's swelling up because
yeah.
We're putting medicine in that tissue.
Is it starting to get numb?
I don't know. He's doing great.
You're doing really good.
That's right. Pain is weakness leaving the body.
Okay, so we injected about 4 cc's. I'm just going to stop there, give him about a minute, and we're going to start reducing. I already have some pre-cut. I'm just going to measure, and this actually we have to cut off because it's in the wrong way. And I'm just measuring to see if it's going to. This is plaster type stuff, but it's pre-made, so it'll absorb humidity from the air and it'll harden. So it used to mean we have to wet these, but you don't have to do that. And some people still do. It's not wrong to do, but you don't have to. It'll harden now. And this is temporary. It'll last a good week if you're careful with it, but eventually it needs to be replaced with casting material.
Okay.
Just feel numb? Well, no,
yeah,
soon enough.
A little.
I can push on it.
It hurts a little.
Sure.
Yeah.
I mean, he's better by this, so I'm just going to keep going. So you basically want to do some traction, and then use this thumb to kind of push it back in.
Good job, baby.
And I try to overdo it because the last thing you want is to do it partially and then get an x-ray later and you don't really do anything. So I overdo it. I push as hard as I can the wrong way. And then we're going to splint you right there. So before we splint you, we're going to use this.
So that set it back in place?
Hopefully.
Okay.
We'll do an x-ray to see where we're at. What I'm going to do is once I go with the splinting stuff, then I will kind of put a little more pressure in. The problem is what I was saying before. Because it's so loose, there's nothing really holding in place. I let it go and it had in position and it falls back down. So what I got to do is reduce it and then hold it in position. It's just like a box. Could have stayed. thinner one, see? When you put in these wrap around, you don't want to put too much tightness. You just want to roll it into the hand. If you put too much tightness, then they can get a swelling later on, and then it's too tough for them. Now here, maybe a little bit more tight, because that's the area I want them to hold on to.
Is this still hurting you?
And then whenever you splint anything, you always want to do it as close to anatomical, what's called the anatomical position for the hand. It's kind of like a little bit hyperextended, a little bit like you're holding a ball there. So what I'm going to do is go like this. So you go up on the wrist, and then this you want like this. So I'm going to hold in position for about a minute until it hardens like that. And once it hardens, it'll be as hard as the cast. Because this is old casting material here. So on a scale of 1 to 10, how bad was that?
Five.
Okay. We didn't need to do sedation, we didn't need to do shots and everything, all the local one. Now, we can give him Tylenol codeine for the pain if he needs to, Motrin for the inflammation, swelling, things like that.
Okay.
And of course, he needs to follow up with the orthopedic doctor, which will be on the paperwork.
Okay.
What is it, Wednesday today, so Friday or next Monday even. It'll last that long. It'll last a week if you take care of it. Taking care of it means don't get it wet, mostly. So when you take a shower, put it out, or put it in a bag, and tie the bag, you can take a shower. But do not take it out, because if you take it out, it'll fall back in. It'll fall back out of position.
Okay. We'll get you there just as soon as we can.
Okay, stretch your arm for me. I'm going to cut the little excess here. Get another x-ray and we'll see how well we did.
Okay.
And then I'll bring you pictures of the pre and post and we'll compare those two.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you.